Grant Killen, everybody.
Wonderful, wonderful.
All right, I did want to make a clarification, just a bit of housekeeping here involved. I believe there's the people by the door who may be unaware. This is not a competition to be louder than the people who have a microphone. I appreciate the effort. That competition is next week, so you guys are welcome to try for it then. If you're saying anything, I can't fucking hear you, because again, big ass microphone here. So, up next, our next comedian is a doctor, so if you need a prescription filled, he's taking the evening off. Don't worry about it. Give it up for Mr. Dr. K!
All Kia car dealers are going to hell!
Yes?
They keep selling their souls. I wanted to get a Jeep Grand Cherokee, but I couldn't get one. So I settled for a Jeep Grand Caucasian. It's part Cherokee, but we can't prove it. It's not on the lows. Dr. K, live from Oklahoma. Oklahoma is number one in tornadoes and divorce. Two ways to lose a trailer. I've always wanted to open a trailer park in Moore during the springtime. Make money flipping houses. Too soon? In Oklahoma, our state senate is made up of registered Republicans, registered Democrats, and registered sex offenders. Now, in all fairness, when a politician runs for office, he registers, pictures of him are posted up all over the neighborhood, and he has to go door to door telling people that he's running. That's a sex offender tutorial. Once he's hung, he has the hangout. We can't let him go into a half cock. I'm part Irish and part French. So when I go into a bar, I pick a fight and then surrender. You want a piece of meat? We can have one. I saw a guy walk into a bar wearing an NFL jersey. He said, "Why are you wearing your wife beater in public?" And then I surrendered. No, I'm a little badass, according to my proctologist. I owe money to my proctologist. I'm in arrears. Usually he's the one that's in the holes. My proctologist always takes his glasses off before an examination. His hindsight's 20/20. I went to a urologist recently. I was concerned that I might damage my kidneys by drinking contaminated water in Michigan. Doctor said, "Yep, you've got Flintstones." I'm old school. First time I saw a karaoke machine, I thought it was a record player, closed caption. How nice they have a TV screen to share the lyrics with the deaf people. I thought plentyoffish.com was a website for mermaids. Now I know mermaids aren't real. If mermaids were real, you would never hear land ho. You would hear sea ho. If you had a mermaid strip club, the place really would smell like seafood. Speaking of strip clubs, I hear that the Red Dog Saloon now has a dispensary next door called the Green Dog. Why don't they just combine the two businesses? Call it the Stoner Boner. We have doobies and boobies. But back to plentyoffish.com. When I was single, when I was on that site, I noticed that several women wrote in their profiles, "I'm not interested in FWB. What do they have against Free Will Baptists?" I know what they meant. They meant friends with benefits. Friends with benefits means that what used to be wham, bam, thank you, bam, is now hunch, crunch, and let's do lunch. You know, black people don't call it friends with benefits. They call it homosexuals. You know, if somebody hires a prostitute without arranging it for a pimp, they're buying wholesale. I hear that Mexican pimps have the same slogan as Corona beer. I help you find your beat. I wouldn't know, because I've never hired a prostitute. When I was single, I would just take a woman out to dinner every weekend, not caring if sex was on the table. But when it was, I got banned from that release. The manager said, "Don't ever come here again." We weren't at it that long. I once had sex with a Chinese woman, and I got horny an hour later. I once dated a woman who drove a Volkswagen Beetle. She gave me herpes. I caught the love bug. I hope I remembered all my notes now. I'm getting old. I have a rescue dog. I found him out on the streets. I took him in, posted pictures of him all over the neighborhood. This is a found dog. Took the dog door to door and said, "Anybody lose a dog?" I had to stop doing that, because people thought the dog was a registered sex offender. Okay, remember our license plates. Let's say Oklahoma is okay. And then they changed it to Oklahoma, Native American. Then during the COVID pandemic, Oklahoma, don't worry, it's just allergies. Or in the springtime, it's stop freezing and start sneezing. You know what allergies are like in Oklahoma? In the springtime, you get people going to church just to get free Kleenexes at the altar. Don't lay hands on her, Pastor. She was just cleaning her garage yesterday. Anyway, the reason I brought that up, I'm not because the jokes were funny, because I don't think they were, but I don't do parody songs in my act anymore, but I feel since I'm dressed as Weird Al tonight, I've got to do one. So here it goes. Oklahoma, where the powwies fogging up your brain, and the dust and ragweed will make your nose bleed, and you find yourself praying for rain. Oklahoma, will I suck thorn, honey, lemon, haw. And then we sneeze and cough and wheeze with dry skin, chat, lips, and itchy balls. We know we belong to the land, but the air's giving us holding lands. And when we say, choo, and wipe the snot away, we start cleaning up the ties in Oklahoma, Oklahoma. Stay in and sleep, to relax and breathe, Oklahoma. Okay, choo, that's my time. Thank you very much.
Keep it going for Dr. K, everybody. Our next comedian has been referred to